Ladies and gentlemen, let me first congratulate Nandan and Aparna for this wonderful book, India's Sporting Transformation. I was fortunate to have a glimpse of it on board the flight today, and I really truly enjoyed reading it. Particularly, I loved the chapter by Abhinav Bindra on his quest for Olympic gold. And it's a fascinating article on how he focused on adaptability, balance, and most of all, his hunger for the Olympic gold. And it's quite an amazing article. And the second one was about Mr. Gopichand and how he's built such a disciplined academy and how he's really trained a whole range of great sports people around it. I'm particularly delighted that to address this room full of very avid and very passionate sports enthusiasts at this concluding session of the third annual Sports Law and Policy Symposium. Sports is extremely close to my own heart, and I'm particularly glad that our only individual Olympic gold medalist and a champion truly both on and off the playing field, Abhinav Bindra, is also in this session today, along with other distinguished panelists. I was very fortunate to go and see his targeted performance center today, and I was really delighted at what he has created, which is truly high tech, and it was quite an amazing experience. But I was also truly delighted at what Mr. Vivek Kumar has created through this his whole contribution of selling off his company, whatever resources he got, he put into this infrastructure for sports in Bangalore, and has truly created a wonderful center where he's got Mr. Prakash Padukone and Rahul Dravid, and he's got a whole range of sports around this. I had not seen such a unique ecosystem for sports anywhere else, and I think this is truly a unique model of sporting infrastructure creation, which I think we should try and see that it's taken to other parts of India as well. Ladies and gentlemen, I really think that sports today in many, many ways are driving India forward. Sports, when I was growing up, was a very low priority item. And people like me who played sports for in our school or college always used to think whether we'll ever get jobs when we grow up. But today, you know, it was essentially seen as an extracurricular activity. You know, it was said that you must focus only on academics and you can play one sport. But today, I think we're really breaking new grounds. Sports is cool. It's a matter of national pride. People like Abhinav Bindra and many of you who are here today have brought great honor to this country. And this change really has been brought in not because of government, not because of merely the private sector, but because of the passion of our different athletes who've done extremely well. It's the passion, commitment, and dedication of our athletes who've done extremely well. And increasingly, sports are getting linked to the economic growth and economic progress of this country. I think they're linked. If India is to be a $5 trillion economy in the future, sports will have to play a very critical role, because sports are linked to fitness, they are linked to health today, they are linked to media, they are linked to entertainment, they are linked to hospitality, and more than anything else, they are linked to tourism in a very big way. And sports therefore play a critical role in every single aspect. I think there's a huge growing ecosystem of sports. Massive ecosystem of sports. There are professional leagues, there are the whole range of IT tech driven businesses. You have new unicorns like Dream 11 emerging out of sports creativity. There's massive media rights. There's corporate support. There's investment in infrastructure. As I saw today morning, there's state-of-art training center, and there are sports management companies. And I think this whole aspect of the sports ecosystem, to my mind, not only exists in Bangalore, but will grow and expand across India. It'll grow into tier two, tier three cities as we go forward. So, ladies and gentlemen, to my mind, there's a massive opportunity about sports. Sports is truly about being a great economic multiplier. There's huge, massive potential of sports in tourism. You just saw the World Cup in England. Almost half of Delhi, half of Mumbai, half of Bangalore had descended to UK to watch the World Cup. And therefore, I think there's a huge possibility of making sports as a driver of tourism in many ways. It's we've seen also electronic sports being driven. I spoke about Dream 11 emerging as a unicorn. But there are a whole lot of chess championship happening in sports all on mobile. And, you know, I'll talk about the whole aspects about data, artificial intelligence and sports at length. But there's a whole aspect of technology-driven business. And my view is that tourism, sports tourism and sports by themselves and sports entertainment can all become a major driver of growth with employment. It can be a very big catalyst of job creation because this sector will also be driven by event management, hospitality, and there'll be there are huge aspects. There's huge possibility of tax revenues for the government, state governments and central governments. And I think one of the issues which needs to be debated and discussed by all of you is what should be the legislation for sports betting, because the Mudgal committee report had talked about it, the law commission has talked about it, and therefore we need to open up a debate and discussion whether we can capture revenues and put it back into sports in some way. And I think there's many of the passionate sports lover who can discuss about it. I think we need to coordinate on this sports growth involving all stakeholders, particularly several states. While Karnataka has taken the lead, I've seen several things happening in Tamil Nadu, several things happening in Kerala. One of the states which has done enormously well in recent times is the state of Odisha. I mean, it's been driven with huge political and administrative will in the state of Odisha, and therefore states must take championship role in this. We need to really truly connect the dots, enable growth with direct change. We need to frame policy which are based on best regulations across the world. And we in Niti Aayog will be very happy to have some of the best performing sportsmen and some sports lovers to join us together in Niti Aayog. We'll be very happy to create an advisory committee which can take this forward as to how do we make India a great center for sports in many, many ways. And this advisory committee can really, really, really look at the future of how do we drive growth in many of these areas. You know, because it's important to do this because just about a year away is the Tokyo Olympics. And just 1 year away is the Tokyo Olympics. And the fact is that we need to produce great Olympians and great Olympic champions like Abhinav. We need to get many more state governments like Odisha who'll actually sponsor sports. You know, I was particularly delighted because actually the state of Odisha sponsors the Indian hockey team. No other state does this, but they sponsor the whole Indian hockey team. And, you know, one of the great things that's happening in this building of ecosystem is that any time any sportsman does well, in any game, any sportsman does well, the Prime Minister of India, Mr. Narendra Modi, himself tweets and congratulates the medal winners. And anybody who's done this has been congratulated by him. So we are trying to, he's himself, the Prime Minister, the first citizen of this country, is himself encouraging, promoting sportsmen. First time we've seen a sportsperson like Tendulkar get the Bharat Ratna, and the rules were amended for that. The highest award in this country for the first time was given to a sportsperson. You know, every single issue, you look at it, you look at the elections, you look at the Swachh Bharat campaign, every single issue, the brand ambassadors are really sportspersons. And many of these issues where we are trying to spread consciousness, awareness, we are trying to bring in, sportspersons as the true catalyst of change. I spoke about technology, which is driving this. Many, many unicorns will emerge from sports in due case. To my mind, You know, many, many sportsmen, my perspective is that in the years to come, the real Richie Riches of India will be the sports persons of India. You know, all the wealth in India will be created through sports people. I mean, just look at this. Virat in Forbes magazine, $36 million. You know, I mean, that's the kind of wealth sports is creating. I mean, Kabaddi players, 1 crore contract. Never heard this before. Game like Kabaddi, 1 crore contract. And many of these will become stars because all of them now have biopics around them. Each one of them. There's a film, Bhag Milkha Bhag. You know, Milkha Singh, you have untold story, Dhoni, you know, and then you have a film on Marie Kom, and then you have Dangal on the Fogel sisters, and then you have Saina Mahiwal, and next you'll have a great film on Abhinav Bindra. So all of them, and I'm quite sure that'll be a resounding success story. It'll be a box office winner. So all these are really signs of great things happening in the world of sports, to my mind. And this is truly remarkable what is happening. I was here, you know, in this session, really my perspective is that we should be able to work towards a very actionable outcomes and practices that can be used across states and across sports in India towards helping to achieve a really two-pronged result. We have a singular goal to help truly transform India and to make it a truly world leader across parameters. And I would truly like Niti to also work with the sports. We work with sports ministry, we work with states in spreading education, health, nutrition, many things. But I think we truly like to work in the spirit of collaborative and competitive federalism by truly providing a huge impetus to sports more than anything else. You know, the sports ministry has led several initiatives like Khelo India. They are successfully trying to bring awareness and engagement. Similarly, the Sports Authority of India has shown the intent, the aptitude, and of course the infrastructure they've created. But we now need to make India, we need to spread it in a manner that sports become replicable across, great models become replicable across India. We are able to create this kind of a huge spirit of creating great sports person, providing the right ecosystem for sports across India. And my belief is that we must make all efforts to become a hub for sporting excellence. And there is a at the same time, this would really need some cutting edge technology. I am a great believer that it will be possible if in the sphere of sports, we are able to push the boundaries, we are able to use artificial intelligence and its possible synergies for sports and use technology for improving sports outcomes and inputs. I'm a great believer that particularly in the city of Bangalore, which has made some very radical transformation because of cutting edge technology and artificial intelligence is making a huge difference. One of the studies by Accenture in recent times has said that actually by 2030 it will create $16.7 trillion worth of economy, which is more than what the USA and China growth output will be by 2030, and that for India itself it'll contribute to about 1 trillion. PwC's another study says that it'll create really about $1 trillion to India's economy by 2025. And it will disrupt many sectors. And why it will disrupt is simply because every single sector of India's economy is getting digitized. You know, in direct tax, 99.6% of Indians pay direct tax online. 95% of it gets settled online. The goods and services tax is all paperless, cashless. The new Ayushman Bharat scheme, which covers 500 million Indians, which is more than the population of USA, China, and Mexico, is all paperless, cashless. And there's digital payment. Each one of us is using the unified payment interface to do direct digital payment. And therefore, all this is leading to a huge amount of data. And actually, if you look at our mobile data consumption, India's mobile data consumption is more than the mobile data consumption of USA and China put together. So India is throwing up such enormous amount of data And this data will be used for analysis. And as has been rightly said, India will be data rich before it actually becomes rich. And therefore, this rich data, many of our fintech companies will use this data for driving growth, for doing artificial intelligence. And to my mind, artificial intelligence is really the future of technology. And it's at its core, it is disruptive, it is transformative, and it is revolutionary. And AI is today potentially the most lucrative commercial opportunity in the rapidly evolving global economy. For India, this means limitless, absolutely limitless potential, including in sports. And we in Niti Aayog are taking the lead for India through a program called Artificial Intelligence for India and Artificial Intelligence for All. In sports, artificial intelligence is well known for its biomechanics, value addition, the future of harnessing data towards analyzing strengths, weaknesses, and opportunities. This can redefine excellence, melding natural talent with access to relevant analyzed data that can optimize results. Our ability to achieve sustained success on the world stage, and this I'm repeating, our ability to achieve very sustained success on the world stage will be a very critically dependent on not merely having the best talented sportsmen, but how do we use cutting-edge science, how do we use cutting-edge technology, how do we use analytics, how do we use cutting-edge medicine, and these are basically will become the backbone of successful sports centers and sports destination. Sports analytics by itself has been forecasted to grow at a CAGR of almost 57% between 2017 and 2021. So it's a massive business opportunity. Technology in sports begins with everybody doing wearable tech to measure, gauge, and improve performance, or just monitor health. And we monitor either health or our susceptibility to injury. Technology has enabled taking away geographical limitations to a very large extent. There's technology for monitoring, governance, transparency, including in refereeing of matches. It allows for greater engagement through online initiatives and interaction, as well as far more enhanced and nuanced content availability. Digital platforms for content are also very, very rapidly advancing. Hotstar during IPL 2019, in fact, had a staggering 300 million viewers. IPL 2019, Hotstar, 300 million viewers. And therefore, technology in sports has also seen the emergence of some of India's most exciting startups in fantasy, sports, and gaming. And artificial intelligence is changing how we approach even traditional behavior and activity. Just imagine what it can do to change how sport is played, gauged, or perceived. The spectrum of artificial intelligence in sports is likely to be extremely, extremely broad. It is likely to be extremely expansive, from funneling and channeling data to tailoring it to sportspersons' needs and performance, to helping prevent and recover from injuries, to altering the fantasy sports experience, even to how viewership experiences and engagement are developing. All this will be driven by technology. Esports are becoming a fast growing, rapidly growing and expanding area, and rapidly becoming a core part of regular sports activity. Recently AI had actually developed a new sport. Artificial intelligence had developed a new sport called Speedgate, merging the concept from sports like rugby, football, and even croquet. Six-player teams kick a ball around a field with three gates. And in a sports conceived through just data from 400 popular sports around the world, the data was crunched to help create a basic framework of rules and concepts. So you will see new games emerging out of technology, new games emerging out of data, new games emerging out of the use of artificial intelligence. IBM's Watson technology pours over millions of minutes and audio video bites of tennis matches at Wimbledon, providing the most relevant highlights of monitoring the players' gestures, the crowd's reaction, and even the commentator's excitement level. Every little bit is monitored. FIFA at the World Cup is known to have provided each team access to a tablet-based system featuring match team access to a tablet-based system featuring match footage, positioning data, and all other statistics in an enhanced analysis of data for better performance. And I can assure you that the team which won had the best access to that tablet. You know, it wouldn't have performed that well without going for technology. So it's all being driven by technology now. But let us for a minute really look at India, and my view is that India could well become the repository of leading cutting-edge and best-in-class innovations, and we must make every effort to ensure that this opportunity is maximized by us. It'll lead to innumerable synergies that will arise at each succeeding stage of development. AI for all must, at the very least, include the sports ecosystem. And I'm saying this in Bangalore because Bangalore is truly the heart of it all. Bangalore is the city where over 400 artificial intelligence startups are working using data and driving India's growth. So therefore, if radical transformation has to be made, if radical growth has to happen, if artificial intelligence is to drive India's sports, Bangalore is truly the heart of it all. I would like to also focus on sports tourism because, to my mind, it provides India with a massive opportunity. It is just a least exploited opportunity of India's tourism products, and one that can be pushed for job creation and for attaining synergies with India's very rich and diverse culture, from the extensive coastline and the aquative opportunities that it offers. We have massive opportunities. This sports tourism can be developed, promoted, and India can be a land of adventure, led in large part through promoting sports-related activity. My view is that there is a huge potential for private sector play in sports tourism. The role of the private sector is very multi-pronged, and it is already getting in place to a large extent in scope, but not yet in scale. And therefore, we need to bring in size and scale. IPL was nothing but sports tourism, and therefore every single city of India has a local sport, and every single rural area has a sport, and each one of them can be driven through tourism. And I think we, on the part of government, will be very happy to play a role which can be, we can act as facilitators, as catalysts. We can synergize the roles and encourage the presence of a whole lot of players in driving this. I was really glad because I had the chance to visit Abhinav Bindra's center before coming here, and I was extremely impressed with what I saw. It's truly outstanding, and it's truly global in size. It's truly world class. And what is being accomplished in India across parameters at this high tech center is really amazing. And my desire is that all coaches of India must get trained at this center. If they get trained, they'll get to know what kind of great facility has been created. And it's not just one center. He's created 5 centers. And if coaches get to learn about what technology can do to a sports person today, it'll make a huge difference to the way he plays, to the way he manages his injuries, to the way he bends, to the way he moves, the way he plays. It'll make a massive, massive difference. And therefore, there is a huge, huge opportunity in using technology, as I said, and Abhinav's center provides a massive opportunity. It shows another example that actually state governments and central governments need to work in private-public partnership with many, many passionate players like Vivek and many of you who've done such great role. And we in Niti Aayog will be truly demonstrate our willingness towards providing assistance in furthering this goal. We remain committed to help. But, you know, much like Bangalore has been able to create this ecosystem, I think we need to create this ecosystem in many other Indian cities, in Lucknow, in Kanpur. You know, when I was growing up in Lucknow used to have a very famous cricket tournament. It's all died out. When I later went to Allahabad, it had a very good football tournament. I grew up watching hockey in Delhi. All these tournaments have over the years died out simply because of the craze for cricket. You know, we need to bring back many of them back. And I think today is really the time and the opportunity to really drive this. Sports leagues in India have evolved truly as great plug and play opportunities for a range of sports. While not every league will be a massive success, I do believe that will help commercialize and monetize sports opportunities. We should work with the outstanding precedent of IPL or at least track exposure and awareness. In India, not all sports are created equal, but the league format, as long as it is supported by outstanding training and domestic competition, is a great avenue for popularizing emerging sports, for talent development in sport, and spotting and engaging with a much larger audience. Just recently, I was pleasantly surprised to hear about the Champions Boat League in Kerala. The snake boat race, which we had developed when I was Secretary of Tourism in Kerala. And I spent over 20 years in that in Kerala state. I never imagined that we could have a league tournament around the snake boat race. And, this really shows the huge economic, commercial and business opportunity around every little aspect of what we do in sports. And therefore, to popularize and standardize a traditionally revered competition involving snake boats is both creative and ingenious and shows India's incredible entrepreneurial ability. Equally encouraging are the entities I spoke of earlier, such as sports tech companies. With the growth in participation, especially recreational and the supporting activities, hundreds of thousands of jobs will be created across the country for all those with an inclination towards sports and beyond. Sports tourism too will create many employment opportunities, as will private sector participation. So what does the future of sports in India look like? I think excellence in Indian sport at the international level is inevitable, and many parts are working in sync towards achieving this. I expect to see a lot more in the near future and a seamless working of all parts in harmony with each other. I think I'm extremely optimistic. I feel that sports is at its core is very, very critical, much like what we are driving, what the Prime Minister is driving through yoga, Ayurveda, much like we are driving nutrition. I think the next big drive of growth will happen from sports. And I look forward really to this great day when we'll produce many, many, many more champions starting from the Tokyo Olympics. And more than that, I think giving a huge impetus to regional sports, to sports which happen in tier 2, tier 3 cities, sports other than cricket. I look forward to a great day when we'll be creating many, many champions in many of these areas. I look forward to the takeaways from today as the start of a dialogue with the sports ecosystem to give stakeholders a truly great opportunity to trans the sports landscape. We look forward to facilitate at Niti, we really look forward to facilitate dialogue and creating a thought leadership, really a thought leadership about sports. How do we take it? What should be the direction? What are the path-breaking things that's happening across the world? What are the best practices? How do we evolve as a nation as far as sports are concerned to create great champions? And we Niti Aayog will be very happy to work in partnership with all the great passionate lovers of sports who've assembled here today. Just wonderful to be always here. Great to see the spirit of sports and great to release such an outstanding book. My compliments to Nandan and to Aparna for such a fascinating book. It's a must read for everyone and I'm sure it'll be a resounding success story. Thank you very much. Great pleasure being here. Love you.